So in the Bible, in Genesis 3, we are told that the serpent was the most subtle of all the beasts of the field that the Lord God had made. But obviously the serpent can speak to Eve in full sentences. The word serpent is nakash. It means to whisper a magic spell. What I find fascinating is the hieroglyph of Akhenaten and Nefertiti clearly shows a serpent race destroying a sheep race within the host body system. The child that Akhenaten is holding in the head of the child is a dead sheep with its tongue sticking out, and then a reptilian in the fetal position. The child's head is literally an egg housing a dead sheep and a reptile. So the sheep is dying and the reptile is benefiting from the death of the sheep within that hieroglyph. How fascinating that the largest church in the world is identical. The Vatican is a serpent, and the mouth of the serpent is a dead sheep made up of angels. There are so many images in the folders that the Lord has let me produce that have the same exact agenda. A card that my wife gave me has a serpent eating a sheep, a card, a greeting card. Downtown Grand Junction has a statue of a guy hugging a girl, and that statue has the identical agenda as the greeting card my wife gave me. So I have a picture of me hugging my wife, and my wife handed me a card, a greeting card with a serpent eating a sheep. There's a statue in downtown Grand Junction that's a guy hugging a girl, no different than me hugging my wife. And there's an image of a serpent killing a sheep. How fascinating. The same agenda over and over and over again in different forms, whether or not it's a statue in Grand Junction, whether or not it's a building called the Vatican that's a big snake eating a sheep in the form of angels, whether or not it's a hieroglyph from ancient Egypt of Akhenaten with the serpent being inside of his body holding a hybridized kid, then the kid's head is an egg housing a reptilian and a sheep with its tongue sticking out, which is the same agenda of the things I just previously mentioned. The litany of information within the folders is identical to the same agenda. It's a consciousness from one place, the pit, serpent. The serpent being from the pit, killing the angel being from heaven within the host body system. The data doesn't lie. It's absolutely perfect. And that's what the Bible says. The Bible says, when you walked according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that works in the children of disobedience, the word spirit is a superhuman angel, comma, demon. So you have a dualistic spirit, an angel at war with a demon within you. It's not outside of you, it's within you. And the only way to win the battle is to surrender to Jesus Christ. That's why he was crucified in between Jesmus and Desmus, representing our condition, a good you and a bad you, a right side up you and an upside down you. The serpent race is taking over the host body system, and the goal is to destroy the sheep race. That's what the end of the world is all about. Just look at the Scion commercial, Toyota. Look at the Smirnoff commercial. Look at the folders. They all bear it out. And God sent Jesus, his son, and the likeness of sinful flesh to destroy the works of the flesh and to pay for all your sins you committed in the flesh. It's the only thing that makes sense of the world. And I pray you turn to Jesus with your entire heart, because the time has come, the world is coming to an end.
Betty?
Oh, and me.